AZTEC Nation, welcome. I'm John Schaefer for GoAztecs.com as we continue through our version of the 2020 AZTEC football season with a look back on some of the more memorable games of the past decade. And today we're going way back, all the way to October of 2010, the first time Brady Hoke was the head coach of the Aztecs. State came into their game against nationally ranked Air Force, having lost two of its last three games and hadn't beaten a ranked team in 14 years. State led 10-6 at the break thanks to freshman Ronnie Hillman's 65-yard touchdown midway through the second quarter.
Freshman running back breaks a tackle. Here he goes. Off to the races. The cutback. The jump. Gonna be a touchdown.
We move ahead a little later to the third quarter. Same score when things start to become interesting.
Army's last win goes back to 96 in the CIC trophy. Finley airing it out. Brown, intended receiver, not close, incomplete. Reverend stride for stride with Vincent Brown downfield. And the conference coming in. Hillman, already over 100 yards, tripped up. Remember last year, 47-yard punt return for a touchdown. Head-to-head with San Diego State. Lindley, deep ball. Brown brings it in, sideline route, perfect pass. Remember does make the tackle, but the chains finally move for San Diego State through the air. Gain of 32, Vincent Brown makes a nice grab.
That sound you just heard was Ryan Lindley taking a deep breath and a sigh of relief. Finally, he's able to connect with his number one weapon, Vincent Brown, on the corner route. That's the accuracy. When you set your feet and you have time, Ryan Lindley can make those throws. That's the reason he leads the Mountain West Conference in passing. Hopefully, as a player, those types of plays can get you settled down.
Brown, 9 career 100-yard receiving games, including last week against BYU. Hillman. A couple tacklers miss, and Wyoming finally stops him and puts him backward. Tough. Play fake. Lindley, trouble, down he goes. Hennessy got their first big sack. Patrick Hennessy of Air Force, loss of 12. 3rd and 19. Lindley, time. Lindley throws. Sampson makes the catch. Sampson inside the 10. Finally tackled by Hennessy, not before a gain of 37. First and goal, San Diego State.
Well, when we talked to this coaching staff, they said DeMarco Sampson at the top of your screen is like a rebounder. He's tall and rangy, just does a skinny post, does a good job of stopping and coming back for the football, keeps inside position on Reggie River, who did not have any safety help on the inside. Just a good pitch and catch by this Aztec offensive play call. That's the execution that Al Borges is talking about.
First and goal, San Diego State. Hillman pinballed around. And Hennessy, along with P.J. Adeji-Paul, make the tackle for Air Force. Going to be here. Lindley throws end zone, looks for Brown. Rembert on coverage. Incomplete. Very well covered by Reggie Rembert. It'll be 3rd and goal. 3rd and goal. Sullivan to the right of Lindley here. Lindley, time, throws, touchdown! Gavin Escobar with an unbelievable one-handed catch. How about it?
This is the focus and the concentration the coaches love to see. Great effort by Gavin Escobar. The player that had the tremendous block on the first half with Ronnie Hillman running the football makes another great play. For a redshirt freshman, Al Borges paid him a tremendous compliment. He said, this young man will be a record breaker before he's done here in San Diego.
Abel Perez tacks on the PAT, and what a catch by Escobar, redshirt freshman. Starting his battle with cancer now. Clark on the carry, wrestled forward. Nice run, Asher Clark. On first down. Adam, thank you. It's Halderman on the pitch. Nice pickup there for Air Force. Chains move again, gain of 11. Nebraska lost to Texas, ranked number 5 this week. Jefferson, a pitch. Nice catch made by Warzika. Shoved out of bounds. Right in front of the San Diego State bench. This is fun. Gotta love college football, all the changes. Gets. Clark. On third down, stuffed. Lawson and Ketchum. Got to Asher Clark, and without star fullback Dylan Free, this is a different looking offense.
I got to tell you, Ernie Lawson may be having the play of the game or be the player of the game with the way he's playing tonight, dominating the line of scrimmage.
Walker is the fullback behind Tim Jefferson. Clark in motion. Jefferson keeps, has the first and more. Preston made a tackle, gain of 6. Chains move for Coach Calhoun and the Falcons. Alderman, the fake pitch. Bootleg, Jefferson throws. Warzika the catch. Long time out of bounds there by Rob Andrews. Gain of 8. Second and 8. And the play clock cycle. Pitch. Clark looks for the edge. Asher Clark has the edge. And has a push down. Gain of 11. Chains move again for Air Force.
About being patient in this offense.
Clark on the pitch. Asher, the edge. Asher on his feet. Asher Clark, touchdown. What a run by Clark for Air Force. 20 yards to pay dirt. And the Falcons right back in this game. Demarath in motion. Pitch. Trouble. Kicked. Ball loose. Perez jumps on it for San Diego State. And the conversion fails to keep it 17-12. But Asher Clark, the junior from just outside Atlanta, third of the conference in rushing yards per game, more than 90. Picks up a huge touchdown for Air Force. Flying toward the end zone. Falcons back in it.
Grab your coat and let's start walking.
Now you can lease a new 2021 Corolla Hybrid for just $239 a month or get $1,250 factory cash back. We make it easy. Toyota, let's go places.
Aztecs had an 8-point lead late in the fourth quarter but missed a field goal that could have put the game away. We pick it back up in the final minutes of the game with Air Force driving for the potential game-tying score.
Is he ever? Walker, touchdown! Is in, and Air Force to within 2, a chance for a 2 to tie it.
You're the San Diego Aztecs. That was too easy with that much at stake to be able to let them score like that. You got to remember, the series before this, Air Force's defense bowed their back and kept San Diego State out of the end zone, and they missed the field goal, but Air Force finds a way to do it, and that's what this Aztec team has missed, is that killer instinct, and clearly, Air Force has it.
All-important two-point conversion. Can they tie this game up? Huge game for the Falcons, thinking about their first ever Mountain West Conference title this year. They still got to play TCU, Utah. Looking for 2. Play fake. Jefferson scrambles. Jefferson throws. They got it. They got the 2. Clark on the catch. Ties the game. 20-20. How about Air Force?
This is just a perfect example of a quarterback making plays. Nothing there. It becomes the scramble drill. Come back, show the quarterback your numbers. Asher Clark
is on the further review.
Asher Clark does what he's supposed to do. Tim Jefferson keeps the play alive. Imperative on a play like this that you extend the play. Tim Jefferson does it. Asher Clark does what he needs to do. And because of the execution of Air Force, they get the 2-point conversion that's now under review.
His knee came very close, Aaron, to being down before he broke the plane of the goal line. I mean, very close.
Well, we remember all of the trials and tribulations that Brady Hoke has had with officiating this year and the impacts that it's had on his team.
Watch the knee here.
It's got to be indisputable evidence to be able to overturn him.
He is down. Did he break the plane with the ball? That's the question. You can't tell from that angle whether the ball was over before that left knee went down. This will be better. Knee down?
Knee down.
I don't think so.
Whoa.
I don't think he got there. You've got to break the plane of the goal line with the ball before the knee goes down. It is so close. Here's another look. Knee down. He's not there.
No, he's not.
He's not there. It's not going to count. Here's the call.
After further review, the runner's knee was down and the ball had not broken the plane of the goal. The try is no good.
This is a two-point ball game, Dave. Remember, if Air Force gets this ball, they don't have to score a touchdown. They merely have to get inside field goal range.
Here it comes. Up for grabs. Aztecs think they've got it at the bottom of the pile. There are bodies everywhere. Officials will unpile the scrum. San Diego State has it.
Coaches all the time, Dave, talk about on onside kicks, you have to be able to catch the ball at its high point. That's exactly what the Aztecs do. Get the ball at its highest point. It's hard to see the number of who that was. DJ Shields, number 85, doing a great job of going up and getting that ball and hanging on to it as the Aztec players dive in and try and rip it out of his hands.
A sophomore from Bonita, California, in the San Diego area. He's been through so many injury issues with a labrum operation, knee operation, and an assuming infection. Missed a lot of time. Huge, huge play. Hillman! Gonna take this one to the house! Touchdown, San Diego State! Offensive coordinator loves it, and maybe the Aztecs just took the next step.
Sighs of relief in the box next to us. Tremendous play by Ronnie Hillman. When San Diego State needed that young man the most, and they needed to score the most, that offensive line, which has struggled up until this year, Aaron Wellman, the strength and conditioning coordinator, all of that put them in a position to be able to punch that ball in. And with 2 minutes left, on the verge of possibly a program-defining win. That is the same power play that they've had so much success on. High school football one-on-one, pull the backside guard, block down, double teams, create a wall, and gas teams up the middle. That's that explosiveness that Ronnie Hillman does such a good job of. When that young man gets to the third level, nobody's catching him.
191 yards and a couple of touchdowns for the kid. True freshman Ronnie Hillman out of the San Diego area. Pretty good bet for the Mountain West Conference. Freshman of the year. It's been a long time. 96 against then 15th ranked Wyoming. And San Diego State has beaten a ranked team. That's about to change. And what an effort by Clark to get in, but a good replay call. No doubt it was the right call. Look out, little slant. Halderman gets smacked. Yarbrough came up and nailed it.
San Diego State playing with some swagger right now. Air Force must keep its composure. Jefferson is an efficient passer. They can't afford to make a mistake and press.
Got two timeouts. Halderman got drilled there by Yarbrough. Sprint left. Ended on the incomplete play of Mikel Hunter by Jose Perez. Wow.
Two thunderous hits back-to-back for San Diego.
This is where you start to flex your muscle, Dave, and this is the types of things that start to happen when you have some success. You become aggressive. You start to trust yourself. You start to trust your teammates. And the reason San Diego State has been in this game, and if they win tonight, is because their aggressiveness on the defensive side of the ball.
Third down numbers. Little slant. Hernice. Felt he was interfered with. No flag. And fourth down. Of course, Jefferson and the offense will stay in the field for short down. Coach Calhoun told us this week he knew San Diego State would be a very tough opponent. Lately, he thinks we'll play in the NFL. Hillman is the best running back since Marshall Faulk here. Throw to Demarath. Jazz brings it in. Inside Aztec territory. Slung down by Perez. Chains move here for Air Force. With a minute 22 to go in the fourth. And two timeouts left for the Falcons. Jefferson pumping. Lets it go. Holloman deep. Downfield. Incomplete. Nearly had it. Those wheels when it matters. Second down. The slant again successful. Warzika the catch inside the 45, down to the 43. Hurry up here. Marcus Andrews makes the tackle. The freshman from Los Angeles for the Aztecs. Third and six. Quarterback draw. Been successful all night. Goes down again. Jefferson piles up the big stats. Perez knocked him down, gain of nine. First down, 48 seconds left. Air Force has got to score here and think about a quick onside kick.
Tell you what, if San Diego State wins this ball game,
Demarath over the middle makes another nice catch.
Great job moving the chains, but if the Aztecs win this ball game, there will be young men and women all over San Diego in their man caves going crazy.
Coach Hope. Hoping to build a program here at San Diego State. Years of struggles. Maybe it changes. The slant has been very successful. Joshua Freeman and Coach Calhoun sprinting from the bench to the officials to get timeout.
Timeout.
26 seconds left.
To the 30-second timeout.
Great job by Air Force putting this drive together. When you take a look at San Diego State and what they have coming up, the win tonight to take them to 4-2 at New Mexico, which has struggled, at Wyoming, which has struggled at times, and Colorado State, all very winnable games. Then they run into the strength of the conference, number four, ranked TCU in Utah, and then UNLV, another very winnable game for this Aztec team. That could be a potential 8-win season. And if that were to happen, looking back, you'd have to think that this game, this hump game over a ranked Air Force team, would have been the turning point for this team. But this game is far from over. Air Force has done a great job, Tim Jefferson, running this team down the field. Now it's up to this Aztec defense to be stout again and keep them out of the end zone. So far, Air Force has wanted it more.
End zone. Broken up. Incomplete. And Hernice, the intended receiver. Inside College Football Extra is coming up here on the CBS College Sports Network when we wrap it up from San Diego. In the conference, Colorado State beat UNLV today. TCU knocked off BYU. And Utah smacked Wyoming to remain undefeated. Air Force 1-for-7, third down tries. Slant again. Touchdown!
That was a catch and a recovery, I think.
Complete a catch and a touchdown.
Did he break the plane before that ball came out, or was that a fumble recovery for a touchdown? Crowd has gone silent here. To Air Force's credit, Coach Calhoun keeping his team composed.
Soderberg in for the PAT. He's got it. So a two-point game, another onside kick coming, one timeout, and a last chance here for Air Force. Last time it didn't quite work out. Good play by Shields with the ball from the air.
Great job by Shields timing the football at the high point. Air Force has some decisions to make. Sometimes teams have a couple different onside kicks if they try. Sometimes it's just a numbers game. It still comes down to execution, Dave, though. And Shields, the last time that Air Force had to do a two-point conversion, or excuse me, an onside kick, was able to go up and get it. Tremendous chance for this Air Force team to keep themselves in this ball game. Still got a timeout left. They recover the ball at midfield near the 40. They can complete one pass, stop the clock, and line up for a field goal. Maybe even a couple passes, depending on how long it takes this play right now.
Shields is back out there along with Escobar. Vincent Brown. Dominique Sandifer. Doug Deacon, a walk-on and a captain. For San Diego State, airborne again. Grab again. Shields. By the Aztecs, it's DJ Shields a second time. How about that? He'll earn top special teams players honors in the film room this week. The sophomore grabs a couple.
Huge play by the young player. Going, doing it again. Timing the ball at its high point. Little too much leg this time by the Air Force kicker Soderberg to be able to get the ball where it needed to be. And barring a disastrous miracle, the Aztecs should win this game and be off and running.
Victory formation for Lindley, and that'll do it.
Sweetest there is in football.
943 yards of offense. There is a timeout called by Troy Calhoun.
Timeout, Air Force. This was their final of the quarter. 30 seconds.
191 rushing yards for Ronnie Hillman and two touchdowns on 24 carries. He has been spectacular, AT, tonight.
He's been spectacular tonight and all season because of plays like this, running well in traffic and getting help from his big guys down the field, being blockers, running them on the way to the end zone. For a young guy to have the vision and the explosion inside the hole that he needs, and this was that last touchdown that they had when they needed it most to put the game away for the go-ahead score. Ronnie Hillman is tremendous, and his upside could potentially be unlimited. Been a lot of talk about him compared to Marshall Faulk. After what I've seen tonight, there may be something to that. Either way, huge win for the San Diego State Aztecs. Possibly a program-defining win. Brady Hoke needed this for his program as they get their first win against a ranked opponent since 1996. And you got to give credit to Air Force. They played their tails off. Tremendous effort on both sides of the football tonight.
Within a video review of tying the game late, Rocky Long, the defensive coordinator, his defense, a great job overall. Let's take a look at tonight's LG player of the game. No question, it's freshman star running back of the Aztecs, Ronnie Hillman. 191 yards, the long went 65 and a couple of touchdowns. I think he'll be the Mountain West Conference offensive player of the week this week. Second leading rusher among freshmen in the nation. Coming in.
State went on to win 9 games in 2010, including a 35-14 win over Navy in front of the home fans in the Poinsettia Bowl. Thanks for watching. I'm John Schaefer. We'll see you next week on Aztec Rewind, presented by your San Diego County Toyota dealers.